DNA replication. And we are going to start with the introduction part of it. So DNA replication is basically the process by which a single molecule of DNA is copied to attain two identical molecules of DNA. And this process of DNA replication is called the semi-conservative process. And this is because when a DNA molecule is copied, a new molecule created contains one strand of the parent DNA and one strand of the new DNA molecule. So DNA replication results into two copies with identical sequences to the parent DNA molecule. So there are four steps which are involved in DNA replication, and these steps are initiation process, the elongation process, the termination, and the proofreading and the correction process. So let's start with the initiation part of it. And initiation is basically opening of the DNA molecule so that the nucleotides can be inserted to create two new strands of DNA. And this process is acted upon by enzyme helicase, which is involved in the opening of the DNA molecule. So enzyme helicase breaks the hydrogen bonds with that all the complementary bases together. And so this unzipping creates a Y shape that is called the replication fork, and the two single strands of DNA becomes the templates of making new DNA strands. So after opening the DNA molecule, or after forming the replication fork, DNA polymerase inserts itself into the replication fork and begins to add new nucleotides one at a time in order to create a new complementary strand. So in order for the action of DNA polymerase, there are some principal requirements that must be met, and these principal requirements include the five triphosphate of the nucleosides must be present, that is the DATP, the UGTP, the DTTP, and the DCTP, which contain the bases of adenine, guanine, thymine, and cytosine respectively. The other requirement is that a pre-existing single strand of DNA must be present, which this pre-existing single strand of DNA is the strand to be replicated, and it must be present. So the other requirement is that the nucleic acid segment, which is called the primer, must be present and must be bonded by hydrogen bonds to the template strand. We have said that the DNA polymerase, the primary is responsible to show or direct DNA polymerase where to begin. You can also see the newly made DNA strand. You can see the DNA polymerase. You can see helicase, which is responsible for the opening of the DNA molecule to form a replication fork. You can see the DNA molecule. It is opened and it looks like a fork. You can also see in the diagram, you can see the nucleotides that are added into the newly formed DNA strand. You can see the lagging strand. You can see the original DNA template or strand. You can see the DNA polymerase is attached to the original template and the lagging strand. So DNA polymerase is basically responsible to add new nucleotides into the newly formed DNA strand. From elongation, we are going to the termination process, and this is basically the stopping of copying of DNA molecule And it happens when replication forks meet each other at the bubble or the end of the linear piece of DNA is reached. So termination results in shorter DNA strands than the original DNA molecule. And you can ask yourself, why is the shorter strand, why does the shorter strands occur? So the answer is, at the leading strand, an RNA primer is laid down to allow polymerase to start placing new nucleotides. When the RNA primer is removed, there is a gap at the 5' prime end of the new strand, and it ends up being shorter than the original DNA strand. The other reason is that at the lagging strand, RNA primers are laid for each Okazaki fragment. So when all these primers are removed and the gaps are filled, there is a gap at the 5 end end of the new DNA that cannot be filled, and this results to a shorter DNA, a shorter strand of newly formed DNA. So how can this problem of shorter DNA being fixed? So the ends of chromosomes contain specialized areas called the telomeres, and these telomeres guard against the shorter DNA strands. So in humans, telomeres consist of the sequence TTAGG, which is repeated several a thousand times. As termination ends, the telomere ends are cut off, making them shorter. As more and more DNA replication happens, the length of the telomere shortens, and this is the reason behind the death of the cell. And basically, the cells cannot live longer. But the solution to solve the problem of shorter DNA is that the enzyme telomerase are related to keeping the telomeres longer, helping them to maintain the long length of the cell, or the long life of the cell. So enzyme telomerase is basically related to the long living of the cell. So from there, we are going to the last process of DNA replication, and this is proofreading and correction. And this is the process by which DNA polymerase moves along the newly completed DNA strands, looking for mismatched nucleotides, and corrects them by inserting the correct nucleotide. For example, if there is a nucleotide like adenine or guanine or thymine or cytosine that is placed in the wrong place, the DNA polymerase detects it and corrects, inserts the correct base. So how does proofreading and correction occur? So we have said that DNA polymerase moves along the newly formed strand, recognizing whether or not hydrogen bonding is occurring. So if hydrogen bonding is not occurring, the DNA polymerase recognizes a mismatched set of nucleotides. So basically, if there is no hydrogen bonding, it means that there is a mismatching of set of nucleotides, and this mismatching is detected by DNA polymerase. So when DNA polymerase detects the mismatching, it corrects the mistake by removing the incorrect base and inserting the proper base. So that's for me today, guys. Please make sure that you subscribe, like, and also leave a comment. Thank you so much for watching.